Hi everyone, today is a great day for us because I'm going to have the opportunity to show you how to use material design icons. I've made a video already on using font awesome or integrating font awesome icons into MAUI application, and now this video is going to help us to know how to integrate material design icon supported by Google into our application. So without wasting time, let's create our project. So now our project is ready, and now what we can do here is let's go in there and grab the font from the GitHub. You know, Google has a GitHub that we can get this font from. So let's launch our browser. So let's go to, that is a github.com, and we have to navigate to Google. Then we're going for their material design and icons. So let's have this. Now we are inside the GitHub. Let's click on font. And now we are going for, you see, we have this material icons.regular. So we have this file as TTF. So let's download this file. So click on this, and I can just click on download raw file. So that is this one. So we have the file over here, and that is this material icons regular. So with this file, let's copy this. Let's go to our project. Now resources. Let's paste it inside the font folder. So here, paste this. Let's go to, so let's grab the name. Let's go to myprogram.cs file. Let's register that. So we can paste the name here. Let's make a copy of this and paste it here. Now let's cut this and we paste it here. So that is the name, and with this we have, so let's clear the space between, and now here we're going to say this is Google Fonts. Okay, let's make the same change to this. Okay. Now set. So now we have this, we updated the project, and let's try to convert this font that we downloaded into C# code. So you can just go to Google and I'll type in something like, so let's convert font to C#, and we can use this. Now let's grab the font here from the download. And that is a font. So let's open this. And this is going to convert it to C#. So that is the font here. And that is a C# code. So we can just copy this. And you can create a class of icon font. So let's go to, once you've copied this, let's go to projects. And here, let's right click and create a new class. So we have to add a class. And on this class, we're going to say icon font. So let's paste what we have in here. So that is a font that we have from Google. And as you can see, it has a lot. Okay, so now let's save this. All right. So now we have this. what is the next thing to do? We have to create a style for this. Let's go to solution. Now, styles, and I open styles.xml file. So with this style, we are going to create our own style for that. So let's put it down here. So here, so let's write, this is customize Google font. So control K. Now down here, we're going to set style. So in our style, let's set the target. You know, fonts affect labels. So target type, we go for label. And also let's give it a key so we can have access to it outside this style sheet. So X type name, or let's make it S type key that we can use often. And now we say this is, so Google font. So that is the key here. Now inside this, let's have our set. So this is our setter. And now with this setter, we are referring to a property type of font family. So font family. And now the value here that we are going for, it is a Google font. When you check the name from here, from the myprogram.cs file, we give it a name as Google font. So let's add Google material font. So let's copy this. Let's go to our style, and now here, let's make it Google material font. After that, let's set the font size of this. So set. Now this, let's type that you want, the property that you want to set here. It is the font size. And now the value is, let's make it 24. Will be okay for now. Let's save this. So we have the key that we can use, like Google font. Now with this, let's go to the main page. So Solution Explorer, we go to the main page. Now in here, let's include our model. So we're going to say X, then models, and we want to have namespace, then application name is demo icons. So we have our models here. We can talk about icon here. So let's use an icon here. Let's clear all this. Or even down here, we can use an icon, and that's going to be the label. Specify text. Another text that we're going to pass in is, we're going to refer to the static resource. And now this static resource, we have it as icons. So icons. And now we can have icon font. That's our class. As soon as I put in dots, we have a lot of icons over here. So we can use any of the icons. So let's say you want to have an login account or login icon. We have specified the size already. So what you have to do here is specify the style. So the style here, and I'm going to use X, the same thing as static resource. And now we're going to have it as Google font. Let's copy this. And now let's make this. Again, so here we have login, and then we have, do you have sign up? So sign up, Okay, so let's see. Oh, okay. So why do you have logout here? Okay, so you have logout. So you can just create something like you can have grid. Then let's have our row definition, which is going to be star star. Then let's have our let's paste this here, and let's have column definition as also 50 50 star, then less like this. Okay, so in here the first one you're gonna have login, so let's pass in the label, and now the test is let's say login, and we want to bring the icon first, so we can just cut this and now put it here. So this is gonna be row one. So this is a row zero, and now here this is also the same row zero. So grid dot row zero, and let's set this to grid dot column one. So this is column zero and this is column one. So you can just make a copy of this. So copy this and paste it here. Now let's make this as logout. And this is gonna be grid.row1 and grid.row1 as well. Row 1. But with this grid.column1. So let's see. Okay, we have specified that here. So let's clear this. Let's save this and now let's run this application and see. All right, so you can see we have the icons over here. Login and logout icons, as you can see from here. So that's the way. It's very simple to use mature design icons from Google integrated into MAUI application, and I use them. Thank you. I believe you enjoyed the video as I did. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. Also, give me thumbs up by clicking on the like button as well. And if you have any issue too, put it at the comment section. Thank you, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.